So a little while ago, I put out the call to review people's websites. I actually meant to say, I'd love to review your clients' websites, but in a Freudian slip, I said, can I review your website? And I got back a great collection of work. And I want to start with this website because this is one of the first that came through my door. Now, how I review websites is kind of based upon three pieces of criteria. How does it look? How does it function? And also, how can we improve this? This is not a full Gordon Ramsay takedown yelling approach. This is, hey, we're here now. How can we make it that much better? Critiques are hard. And I'm always thinking about ways to improve a design and not necessarily tear it down. So this site is Ayub's. I hope I'm saying his name correctly. It was just a submission. And I want to go through his single page website. And let's talk about three things again. How does it look? How does it function? And how can we improve it? So how does it look? At the first glance, it looks pretty good. I'm never a fan of the word home, only because I can click the title of a website in the top left. And so for me, having two pieces to get home, well, I understand the idea of having the underline on this top part. I would just hide it and have IU be the way to get back to the top. This is a single page website. So when I hit the about section, the area of selection will change from about to home. I'm just the person that says home is really becoming outdated in my mind because everyone now knows to click on the upper left of the logo to go back to the home page. That's just a minimal piece. We have I am Walid Ayub. Hope I'm saying it correctly again. If I am not, I am so sorry. I am trying to do the best I can on pronouncing everyone's names appropriately. On the page, about me. I'm noticing all the type. I think we've got some sort of bootstrap going on here because I do like that look. One thing about the skills, I would just basically list your skills. I don't think you need to even say 85, 90, 100. I think you've already got a strong knowledge. So I would just say skills, bullet points, front end dev, back end dev, app development, and design. I wouldn't say you've got relatively a B in design. I would just say you list your skill sets right off the bat. Profile looks good. I would probably capitalize your last name right here. And everything else, whoop, I would might fix the spacing in this piece right here. I think I saw it's usually a 20-year dash old full stack developer. I would just double check that piece going on over a little bit of cleanup on the text going forth. But on the page, services, yeah, web design, development, data analysis, all looks really good here with the cleanliness. I just love the big bold type. I'm not usually a fan of all uppercase type, but there's just such a few amount of words. I'm not having a problem here. The reason why I don't like all uppercase fonts is because it's just really hard to read. If you look at this, if you think about the way you look at books, you read uppercase, lowercase. That helps to catch the eye not reading so fast. But since there's such a few amount of information right here, I don't have too much of a problem in the way how it looks. Work's completed, 4 years. I might center this. I'm usually not a fan of centering type or centering designs, but it feels like there's something missing over here on the right-hand side. So I might just basically move this to the center area of this design. Contact us, get in touch. This all looks really clean. Now let's head to the mobile side. Let's take a look at how it looks both from the desktop and the mobile approach. We'll head back to the top. This overall looks really good with the different pieces, home, about, services. We've already discussed the home piece going on. The one thing I would recommend doing is there's a lot of empty space on the mobile side. I might write a media query if I do this one. Let's see how I accomplish this. I'm trying to do this all live and not stop and start just because I want to do almost a live review of the site. So this table cell, how does it look? It looks good, but if I just find, where is that? 100%. Nope, it's got to be the intro. Somewhere I'm going to find it. I just have to find, there it is, the hero. There's the height I'm looking for. The 100 vertical height is fine on the desktop. I'm just wondering on the mobile site, and this could mess up the way it works with this one as well. So take this with a grain of salt. I'm just wondering if we knock this down to like 50 VH, will it? I'm not quite sure, but I'm just wondering if because this really fits almost in that horizontal pattern and less in the vertical. And if we go to about, I think we're okay. I think you can still get away with the home. And if we go down to about, it knocks it anyway. So basically the top part, I would almost go 50 vertical height in this design. And we can see your picture down below. There is a bit of an issue with the spacing on this left-hand side on the mobile site. I think we just have to basically, we added margin lefts. And since we are using Bootstrap, I'm familiar with that system. The problem is I don't like adding any spacing to an image. To my mind, I think about how can the parent space out the image. The image should fit full width to its parent. When we add a margin left to the image, what happens is that you're kind of adjusting it unequally. And the minute I take out that 10 pixel margin left, we are back in action because the parent controls the spacing, and let's let the parent control the spacing. Everything else looks really good about this. I love the spacing at the top, name, profile. It all moves really successfully. And again, I think we just have bullet points when it comes to front-end dev, back-end dev. I'm never a huge fan when it comes to the percentages, only because it shows the design's a B. I would just list your skill set and just have a list of information. Again, we talked about the spacing and a bit of the grammatical work and other pieces in here. Services look really good. I like how it's open. This is a big thing for me that I like about the mobile site, that it really flows successfully down the page. And again, using Bootstrap, it makes everything easier. This looks really nice. Once again, so this spacing looks fantastic going on in terms of these pieces. It was just when we went back to the desktop. The one thing I did notice, and I think this is because I fixed it. Let me refresh the page. Yeah. This was me. I was checking this earlier and I did kind of do a pseudo change to it and I forgot to refresh the page. So the one thing I would recommend doing, and this is where we didn't look at it earlier because that was my fault, is I kind of went in and fixed this a little bit. So when I refresh the page, these WhatsApp and Instagram icons are not quite sitting in the middle of those circular icons. How we can fix that, if we go into inspect, in here, if we scroll down the page, and if I inspect one of these little guys, I love how the circular works, looks fine there. It's just in this ICO circle, what I can do is let's just flex this little guy. So what I wanna do is let's say display flex, that'll knock it into the flex world. And after that, we can justify the content center, and we can also align items center, and just like that, it does center things. Now, again, it might not look perfect just because the WhatsApp icon does have that little tail on the bottom left, but technically justifying centering in those pieces will hold it to the middle of the design minus any additional design components that we're not seeing in this design. So a minimal area. And again, what I would do is, since we are using Bootstrap, if you do a quick search, I did see Bootstrap in here because I did notice that if I did come up here to the top, this type looks like the Bootstrap lead, which I believe it is. Yeah, we have the P class lead. And if you do a quick Google search for Bootstrap 5 Flex, you can add those automatically into your design pieces at the very bottom of the page going on where it is right here instead of having to write it manually. I just did right here. So overall, how does it look, function? Can we improve it? Overall, I like it. Like, it really says full stack developer, who you are. The one thing I also noticed in taking a quick look, this is a minimal piece. This is kind of just one of my areas. Like, I don't like to do a lot. That when I went back into your title of the href and the logo, I do not make the logo be an h1. The reason why is for searchability, I think about how can the title stand out. And to me, your title is down here. And when I did a quick search of this, lo and behold, it's an H1. Now, I would make this second part an H2. You're kind of skating it. I'm okay with it being a P. But if you think about it, an H1 is a title and an H2 is a subtitle. So if I was me, what I would do is I would make this the subtitle. And you can also, I believe down here, I haven't checked. Oh, no, I'm going to check a couple more things. This could really be an H2 because it's now, you could maybe say the about me might be the H2 in this one. Don't go H4. H5. Oh no. We've just opened a rabbit hole. All right, let's talk about H's. Think about all of the heading tags as in order. So the one of the best tools we look at is Wikipedia. So if I go to Wikipedia and I say like San Francisco, Wikipedia does a fantastic job of this. So if we look at, hello, Jimmy Wales, maybe later. Oh, never mind. San Francisco right here is definitely going to be the H1. Right off the bat, the H1. Now, if we take a look at the H2, we can find it pretty much inside of history right here. I'm going to close the big message by Mr. Jimmy Wales and inspect, and we should have, lo and behold, an H2. We should follow the same pattern with the H's. I rarely will use an H5 in my design. I think about the title being the H1, and you can say full stack developer being the H2, and you stylize this H2 within the hero tag that you have here. You've got a class hero, and with that, what I would do is just do a hero H2 for up here, and then down below with about me, because about me should be the H2. I doubt that should be an H5. This is where, for SEO purposes, Google and other tools likes to be consistent with H's. You only get 6 of them. And if you can get down to an H5, I'm very impressed. I don't think San Francisco even gets to an H5. I think maybe Zero Vision might be, let's see, is that an H4 or a 5? They hit the H5, but that's because they've already got down. If we come back, I should have picked a big, I was trying to find a decent one. But basically, this is an H2, H3, H4. So they barely get to an H5. But with your one-page site, you're nowhere near the H5. I would just flip it to an H2/H3, thinking about, well, your title is who you are, and then your subtitle is about me. And you can also include services as an H2 because it's a different subsection of information about you. Just thinking about using the H's more appropriately. Don't think about design when it comes to H's. Think about what they're really used for. And that's basically to arrange the hierarchy of information on the page. That being said, this looks really good. I mean, I like the overall look and feel. It flows well. I didn't check if it's Gatsby or whatever else, but all I know is this thing loads quick and it was fast. My last little gripe is don't forget to make it secure. And that could be simply as tossing it onto a Firebase console or Netlify or GitHub or anywhere else you store your site. Just make sure it's secure. That's a big thing to me. Google is basically saying we want HTTPS for everywhere. So do what you can to make the site secure. Overall, great site.